Going back to our historical overview of modeling, recall OMT, the object modeling technique, and it had both a structural view and behavioral view, but it had a functional view. And the functional view made use of what are called data flow diagrams. UML does not contain that particular functional view. It uses use case diagrams instead. But I wanted to show you the data flow diagrams because I have found them personally useful in describing systems. In particular, a data flow diagram conveys systems activities and the ordering in which they occur. Data flow diagrams can be nested, and the outermost data flow diagram is called a context diagram. In the context diagram, there's a single oval which denotes the system as a whole. That oval can be connected to various external actors. In the case of the context view, those aren't stick figures, instead they're rectangles, and the actors can be individual users, or they even can be external systems which are communicating with the system that you're modeling. The lines that connect the actors to the system are called data flow lines. That is, there's some communication of data between the actor and the system, or the system and the actor. Here's a context diagram of a system that plays chess. The external actor is the human opponent, and there are three flows of data. The human opponent can submit moves to the chess playing program. Similarly, the chess playing program can communicate moves back to the human opponent, or the chess playing program can produce a diagram of the current board situation.